Have you ever tried to eat really low carb, like no bread, no pasta, no rice, no fruit, but you're still left asking, why did your blood glucose spike after a meal? It's frustrating, right? You're trying to do everything you're supposed to, yet your glucose monitor tells a different story. I know how discouraging it can be to see a big spike after a meal you thought was blood sugar friendly, but don't worry, you're not alone and this is fixable. Spikes happen to a lot of people, and today we're gonna break down exactly why a spike might happen after a low carb meal and what you can do to prevent it next time. I'm Dr. Morgan Nolte, founder of Zivli, where we help you lose weight, keep it off, and get healthy with a low insulin and inflammation lifestyle. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you never miss out on tips that help you live a healthier, happier life. First, let's define a blood sugar spike. According to Levels Health, which is a continuous glucose monitoring company, a spike happens when your glucose rises more than 30 milligrams per deciliter from your pre-meal level. So if your blood sugar was 100 before you ate and hit 130 after, that's considered a spike. Blood sugar spikes are tricky and can lead to overeating. That's because they cause a large release of insulin from your pancreas, and your pancreas isn't perfect. Often it gives you a little bit more insulin than what you really need, so it pushes your blood sugars down even below your pre-meal level, and this can make you feel hungry even though you just ate. Occasional spikes aren't necessarily harmful, but repeated spikes over time can lead to insulin resistance. And here's why that matters. Insulin is your body's fat creation and storage hormone. When you have frequent blood sugar spikes, your insulin levels stay elevated. And when your insulin is high, your body is in fat storage mode instead of fat burning mode. That means if you're struggling to lose weight, especially if you feel like you're doing everything right, but still not seeing results, it's possible that frequent blood sugar spikes and elevated insulin are working against you. This is where wearing a continuous glucose monitor, or CGM, can be so eye-opening. It gives you real-time feedback on how different foods impact your body. And trust me, there will be surprises. You might think a banana is great until you see a 50-point spike on your CGM. But the good news is that when you have the data, you can make adjustments. So let's talk about the two biggest reasons your blood sugar might be spiking after what you thought was a low-carb meal. Reason number one, you're eating more carbs than you realize. This happens all the time. People think they're eating low carb, but they're not actually tracking how many carbs are in their food. And when you're just estimating, it's really easy to go overboard, especially with healthy foods. For example, 2 cups of broccoli and a small apple, right? That's 28 grams of net carbs. And for someone who's insulin resistant, that could be enough to trigger a spike. That's why tracking macros can be a total game changer. The tool we recommend is Carb Manager, and you can get free setup videos at zivli.com/macros. Tracking your food for just a few weeks can give you a much better idea of exactly how many carbs you're eating and where those hidden sources of carbs may be coming from. And the sneaky part is that we tend to justify portions when something is healthy. It's easy to say, oh, it's just broccoli, I can have as much as I want, or it says low carb right on the food label, or keto friendly, or I'll just have a small dessert since I ate really well today. But all those little justifications add up. If you've ever thought, I eat really clean, but I still can't lose weight, tracking your carbs might reveal why. And a little bit of a bonus here too is if you're eating foods labeled as sugar-free or keto-friendly, they might have additives like maltodextrin that can actually raise blood sugar even though they're sugar-free. We have a video coming out soon that teaches you how to properly read a food label and ingredients list to keep an eye out for ingredients like maltodextrin. Now, the second reason is that you might be eating too much protein at your meal. You may be thinking, wait, too much protein can spike my blood sugar? Yep. And here's how it works. If you eat more protein than your body can immediately use, your liver is going to convert some of that into glucose, which is the type of sugar that circulates through your bloodstream and registers on your continuous glucose monitor. That extra glucose can then cause a blood sugar spike, especially if you're eating a really high protein meal. Now, protein is essential for muscle maintenance, especially as we age, but the right amount does matter. For most people over 50, a good protein target is at least 30, but preferably closer to 40 or 50. Grams per meal, and this is about 5 to 6 ounces of cooked meat. A helpful rule of thumb is to remember that cooked meat has about 7 grams of protein per ounce. So if you're measuring out 5 ounces of cooked chicken, you would take 5 times 7, which is 35 grams of protein. And you might think, well, more protein is better, right? Well, not necessarily. If your body doesn't need that extra protein, it won't magically turn into more muscle. That would be nice, wouldn't it? But it actually gets converted into glucose and then stored in your muscle glycogen, your liver glycogen, or your body fat. So if you're consistently eating big portions of protein and wondering why you're seeing glucose spikes, this could be the reason. So what can you do if you're seeing spikes after low carb meals? First, be aware of portion sizes, both for carbs and protein. Just because something is healthy doesn't mean that you can eat unlimited amounts without consequences. Watching portion sizes of healthy fats is important too, because it's easy to overeat fats and get more calories than you need for your desired weight, even though those calories are okay for your blood sugar. Second, if you do want to include some carbs in your meal, eat them strategically. Research shows that eating carbs last after your protein and fat can reduce glucose spikes significantly. Third, slow down your eating pace. When you eat too quickly, your blood sugar will rise faster. This is why guzzling down sugary soft drinks is one of the worst things that you can do for your health. All that sugar, which I call naked carbs because there's no protein, fat, or fiber with it, enters your system so fast when you're drinking it in liquid form. There's nothing to slow its digestion or absorption. So taking your time allows your body to process the food more gradually. Fourth is to pair carbs with protein or fat. A small apple eaten on its own might spike your blood sugar, but it might not if you have it with some peanut butter. And then lastly, be cautious of foods marketed as keto-friendly or sugar-free. There's probably some unhealthy artificial sweeteners in there and food emulsifiers or additives that are spiking your blood sugar, even though they don't contain sugar. To learn more about how to eat properly so that you can attain and maintain your ideal body weight and blood sugar numbers, take our insulin resistance diet blueprint. This three-part video training series will teach you the need-to-know information on insulin resistance and provide clear, concise education on how to eat to reverse it. Now, I'd love to hear from you in the comments. If you've ever worn a continuous glucose monitor, what's the biggest insight that you learned from it? And if you're looking for a little boost to complement your healthy diet and see even faster results in your blood sugar management, I highly suggest the Super Berberine supplement by SugarMD. Along with a healthy diet and lifestyle changes, it can help lower blood sugar levels more effectively than other berberine supplements for two primary reasons. First, it contains dihydroberberine, which is a more bioavailable form of berberine. And second, it contains highly concentrated Ceylon cinnamon, so much that it's like you're getting 3 tablespoons of regular cinnamon in just one serving. There's a link in the description for you to learn more about SugarMD and Super Berberine. Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you're more likely to see when a new video comes out. And if you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about reducing blood sugar spikes, be sure to check out this video next about 7 tips to reduce blood sugar spikes after your meal.